So, how's the real estate market? We're going to talk about that today, both the market in relation to the new realtor settlement, but also the condition of the market at large in the Charleston area. Plus, are these commission lawsuits really over? There's 88 companies that were excluded from the settlement. What does that mean to homeowners when it's selling a house or buying a house? Who's going to pay these costs that are kind of being sent into orbit? Plus, more on the housing business that you'll want to know today. Let's get into the coverage right now and look at some of the headlines that are floating around about how the real estate market is. First, let's go to interest rates. Interest rates easing off this past week just a little bit with news from the Fed. The Fed holds rates steady, indicates there could be three rate cuts in 2024, which matches what we expected in late 2023. But there became this concern that maybe we'd only have two rate cuts this year, this late winter. So that drove rates up again. We saw rates in the low to mid sevens. As recently as a week ago, now rates are, you can find rates in the high sixes. Keep in mind, interest rates as they are quoted are about average over the last 50 years. They're not high nor are they low. So right now, interest rates are average. What people are having a hard time with is that during 3% rates, in some cases, rates as low as 2.5% for a 30-year fixed rate mortgage, we created a market of homes that used to be, say, $500,000 that are now $1 million and $200,000 homes that are now 450, and the affordability factor is pretty rough. But affordability based on income and the overall economy is not as bad now as it was in 2006, even with sky-high real estate prices and what some people think are sky-high mortgage rates. I'd call them average mortgage rates, not high, not low. They're just high because of sticker shock. That means that the average cost of a 30-year fixed rate mortgage on an average home has gone up about 50% in the last 18 to 24 months from the lows during the pandemic when rates were below 3% compared to now. How's the real estate market? The numbers in Charleston point out something that's pretty exciting. We need about 5,000 to 6,000 homes in the Charleston Tri-County area in order to consider it a neutral or healthy, normal market. Right now, we have 3,074 homes on the market as of Friday, March the 22nd at about noon. So we have 3,000, just shy of 3,100 homes. We have nearly 2,900 pending. So if all of those pending homes we're going to close in the next month, we barely have over a month of inventory. The actual numbers, we have about 2 to 3 months of inventory, depending on what segment of the market from Somerville to Charleston, Mount Pleasant, and beyond that you look. Some of the islands are a little slower. We've seen a decline in prices on Edisto Island because they shot way up last year. They kind of lagged behind the rest of the market. We're still seeing acceleration of prices in Mount Pleasant. I've started on my Brian Crabtree Real Estate Facebook page, kind of joking about prices. I'm not trying to make fun of anybody, but I'm looking at some of the not so good deals of the week. But I also point out some of the good deals. So be sure to like my YouTube channel and subscribe, but also check out and like my Facebook page where I put, I hope, what is relevant content for you there throughout the week. Now, I want to talk about home prices over the next 5 years. This is a national graphic, but nonetheless, it's pretty exciting if you look at it. This is a Keeping Current Matters real estate survey. This looks at a lot of different economists and economics toward the housing market. We're talking about the average house in 2024 nationwide. Keep in mind, this number is higher in Charleston, but let's just go with national for now. $400,000, and we estimate, according to Keeping Current Matters, as you see at the bottom of the screen here, that the average house will go up $83,385 over the next 5 years, even if rates stay high, with the economy as it exists now, even if we had a mild recession. The prediction is over 5 years, the balancing act will be a $400,000 house today would be $483,000. If you've got an $800,000 house, that means you'd be knocking on the door of $1 million. So the prices won't be accelerating anything like what we saw between 2020 and 2023, but we are seeing quite a bit of solid energy in the housing market as it relates to what we can expect over the next, I think, at least 24 months. I'm having a hard time finding any data, whatsoever that would predict any kind of a decline in housing prices in the next 24 months, especially when I'm buying into the Fannie Mae prediction, and I don't buy in because they're Fannie Mae. I just think that they're kind of on target here, that interest rates by the end of this year in the fourth quarter will be below 6%, something like 5.75 to 5.875 for a good par 30-year fixed rate mortgage with no points origination. That's just a prediction. It's just an opinion. You can't take it to the bank, but that seems to be what's shaping up for the housing market. So we're looking at great appreciation, something in the neighborhood of what, 20 to 25% over the next 5 years, even as we're in a volatile housing mortgage market, interest rates possibly coming down at the end of the year, Fed policy basically stacking up so that the Fed policy is to start lowering the overnight borrowing rate sometime in the summer, we think, end of second, probably beginning of third quarter. And that is where we start to really look at the market getting hot again. So if you're thinking about buying a house, now's the time. The other factor that I want to bring up today before we close out is the did I lose that on my screen here? Well, I'll have to read it because it disappeared. You love computers, right? So technology is great when it actually works. So what we're looking at in these commission lawsuits, these settlements that have my computer wants to go haywire on me. We look at these commission lawsuits, and there's a report out today from Industry Trades, Riz Media, which is an industry trade magazine in the housing business. It says 88 companies. I think in Charleston, for instance, that might be like a Carolina One. I think they did over $2 billion in sales last year. So they got, you know, sent up the river, basically. And I'm not saying that in anything to be negative or positive about Carolina One. I'm just simply saying if their sales volume as the number one company in Charleston last year was over $2 billion, according to my read on it, they're not out of it. And companies like Weikert Realtors, corporate stores, they have about 200 offices up in New Jersey. And there's big brokerages like the Coal Banker brokerages. If they haven't settled directly, then a lot of these companies, 88 of them, are still in the mix. And I don't know what the agent count is for all those companies, but let's say it's a couple hundred thousand. So the agents may be out of the woods, but the owners of the companies may not. And this is very muddy. And it's really kind of ridiculous in that we've settled a lawsuit, except it's not all settled. So what does the lawsuit mean to you if you haven't seen the other content? The lawsuit basically means that we no longer sit down at the listing table and say to the seller, we're going to offer 3% or 2% or 2.5% or whatever number in the multiple listing service. This should kick in if approved by the judge in July. This means we're not going to sit down and negotiate the commission that we're going to put in the MLS. Now, there's one of two ways this is going to play out, in my opinion. There's the way I want to do it, and there's the way maybe a lot of other people want to do it. The way I want to do it is just walk into the seller and say, I'm going to list your home for it. Right now, I'm doing it at 2% this spring. So 2%, $1 million, 20 grand, 400,000, 8 grand. I list your home. I market it. I do the things that I need to do that I've always done to bring the buyer's attention to your home. How they go about writing the offer and the contract and getting somebody paid for their services is really up to them. They can call me directly. They can go to another agent and pay them. They can make an offer for you to pay the commission to the buyer's agent or to just pay some of their closing costs to offset it. This puts transparency in the negotiation. I think this is a long time coming and it's a good thing. So transparency. And then that way, if there's five offers on your home, which I hope to create, I can then let you choose through those offers based upon the price, the terms, the commission, your net. It's all that's ever mattered to sellers is your net. So the buyer who brings you the best net and the best terms is the one you take. How commission factors into that would be like whether you're going to leave all the furniture or not, or leave the washer and dryer and the appliances. All of that's a negotiation. And I think the more that the seller is empowered to negotiate, the better off it is for the clients I represent, because I'm getting my fee, you're paying me that fee, and everything else becomes in your control. I think this is wonderful. A lot of agents are freaked out. It's crazy, right? But I think the problem is people don't like uncertainty and they don't like change. And I think there's a way to take advantage of it and help your clients, as I plan to do. But also, more importantly, in the industry, the fear, too, is we don't really know if this is all settled or not. So we have to do the best we can. What does it mean to you as a home seller or home buyer? Right now, effectively, at least for the next 90 days, I don't think anything's going to change. It's just going to be a big to-do and discussion. And right now in the multiple listing service, if you're a buyer, the bulk of the 3,100 listings in Charleston, 3,000 of them are paying a co-broke. Your fee's covered with your current agent, or if you use me, you don't have to worry about it for right now. As we move forward a year down the road, I'll be keeping you up to date on what it means. But for real estate transactions over the next 90 days, the foreseeable future, no changes at all, except that some agents like myself will go to sellers and say, listen, I will give you the option of choosing from a menu of options of commission that can range from 2% to 6%. It's up to you, depending on what you think your needs and wants are as a seller. And I think anytime consumers are given options and a company like mine can make profit with those options in place, all of them, it's a win-win for the seller of a home, the buyer who wants that home, and the agents involved in the process. HouseDog.com. If you're needing some help, want a free market analysis, check your home's equity, get a home equity checkup at HouseDog.com. And remember, subscribe to the channel for updates when new videos come out. Have a great weekend.